El Salvador has been torn apart by criminal violence for decades. Yet, homicides have plunged under the watch of the country's millennial president, Nayib Bukele. He is the president with the highest public approval rating in Latin America.
Since Nayib Bukele, the youngest president in the country's history, took office in June 2019, daily homicides have almost halved. What factors are driving the drop in homicides, and what other elements need to be taken into account to prevent the further bloodshed that ultimately drives thousands of Salvadorans to flee north towards Mexico and the US?
Hay un mensaje fuerte que tenés un presidente que no se te duerme, sino que de verdad está presente y con un mensaje de que aquí estoy, soy yo quien está viendo el tema y punto. Y vamos haciendo las cosas de esta forma, eso creo que ayuda, abona mucho, porque tanto te recibe el mensaje la población, como también te recibe el mensaje las pandillas.
The government has attributed the drop in homicides to the measures taken under its new territorial control plan, including security force deployments. But there are some people that question the effectiveness of this plan and call for more transparency.
Tengo dudas realmente sobre lo que pasa. ¿Qué sucede? El plan control territorial ha abarcado 22 municipios. O sea, ahí estoy iniciando el control de los territorios. Pero la disminución de los homicidios me da en los 262 municipios. Entonces hay algo que no me lo explica el plan control territorial. Hay algo que tengo que buscar qué es el efecto de eso. Porque si a mí me operan el codo derecho, no se me va a arreglar el codo izquierdo.
Bukele has also insisted on tough measures against jailed gang members, including through confinement, communications cuts, and prison transfers.
Porque las pandillas no son lo mismo que eran. Y los chicos de hoy en día que andan en la calle, como no tienen rienda, y roban, y extorsionan, y hacen esto, y hacen lo otro, y no les cae a ellos el problema, sino que otra vez a lo mismo. Y el Estado ahí está errado. Que ellos piensan que desde allá sigue saliendo órdenes y siguen saliendo. Y no es así, nadie oye a nadie allá.
So if Bukele's territorial plan and his prison policy are not the sole causes, why are crime and violence dropping in El Salvador?
Puede subyacer dentro de la reducción de homicidios algún tipo de pacto con grupos de crimen organizado, algún tipo de negociación en la cual el gobierno plantee, actúen las estructuras de crimen organizado, sigan cometiendo delitos, pero no provoquen homicidios, porque el aumento de homicidios tiene un costo político y político electoral que este gobierno no está dispuesto a pagar.
Doubts about the effectiveness of the government's security policy also arises from the secrecy with which it has been handled, as no official document of the territorial control plan has been shown to local or foreign observers. At the same time, civil society groups have criticized Bukele's refusal to work with them.
No es desde el proceso de consenso, de diálogo y de generar acuerdos de nación, sino más bien de definir cuál es el rumbo que debe de seguirse y que quien no sigue ese rumbo se termina convirtiendo en un opositor o alguien que está en contra del beneficio del país.
Whether the homicides reduction has been driven by Bukele's security policy or an informal understanding with gangs, the sudden killing spree attributed to MS-13 in April illustrated just how precarious the gang's commitment to reducing violence can be. Bukele's reaction to the attacks, which left over 80 dead in a 5-day span, reaffirmed his inclination to adopt punitive measures to force gangs into submission.
Bukele faces a big challenge ahead, as homicides only explain one dimension of the endemic violence that is plaguing the country. But he also has the political capital to shift away from an approach based on repressive measures that has been dominating the security policy in the country for decades, and build on one that includes prevention, rehabilitation, and reintegration for gang members.
The fall in the murder rate may be only temporary, especially given the threat that the COVID-19 pandemic poses to El Salvador's economy and health system. But if the violence rates stay low, and gangs show they are responsible and sensitive to health and humanitarian concerns during the pandemic, then the government should also consider formally reopening some form of dialogue with these groups, initially focusing on the local level to demobilize them and bring lasting peace.